We're asked to determine the greatest common factor and least common multiple of 36 and 60. We'll find both the greatest common factor, or GCF, and the least common multiple, or LCM, using the prime factorization of 36 and 60, and the Venn diagram shown here. Let's begin by determining the prime factorization of 36 and 60. 36 equals 6 times 6, and 6 equals 2 times 3. 2 and 3 are prime. So we know the prime factorization of 36 is 2 times 2 times 3 times 3, or using exponents, 2 squared times 3 squared. And we should put the prime factors in order from least to greatest. And now for the prime factorization of 60, let's begin with 6 times 10. 6 equals 2 times 3, and 10 equals 2 times 5. So the prime factorization of 60 is equal to 2 factors of 2, a factor of 3, and a factor of 5. We're using exponents, 2 squared times 3 times 5. Now looking at the Venn diagram shown here, we want the set on the left to contain all the prime factors of 36, and the set on the right to contain all the prime factors of 60. In this overlapping region, which we call the intersection of the two sets, would contain the prime factors that 36 and 60 share in common, or the prime factors that are both in 36 and 60. So looking at our prime factors, notice how both 36 and 60 share the prime factors of 2 times 2 times 3, which means we would list two 2s and a 3 in the intersection of these two sets. But determining the common prime factors of two numbers, we're finding the greatest common factor, where the greatest common factor, or GCF, is the greatest factor that divides two numbers. So again, we can always find the greatest common factor in the intersection of the prime factors of any two numbers. Again, these are the prime factors the two numbers have in common, which means the greatest common factor is equal to 2 times 2 times 3, which equals 12. 12 is the greatest factor, or largest number, that divides both 36 and 60. And now we'll complete the Venn diagram and determine the least common multiple. We said earlier this set here must contain all the prime factors of 36. Right now it only contains 2 times 2 times 3, which is equal to 12, not 36. Looking back at the prime factorization of 36, it's missing the prime factor of 3. So this prime factor of 3 would go in this region here, where it's a prime factor of 36, but not a prime factor of 60, already listed here. The set on the right must contain all the prime factors of 60. Looking back at the prime factorization of 60, notice how it's missing the prime factor of 5, so this 5 must go in this region here. 5 is a prime factor of 60, but not a prime factor of 36. From here, we can determine the least common multiple, where the least common multiple, or LCM, is the least number that is a multiple of two numbers, and the LCM is also the smallest number that is divisible by the two numbers. So because we have the prime factorization of 36 in this set, and the prime factorization of 60 in this set, if we combine these two sets, or we say find the union of these two sets, we're determining the least common multiple. So the number that is the product of all of these prime factors will give us the LCM, which means the LCM, or least common multiple, will contain 2 factors of 2, 2 factors of 3, and a factor of 5. So 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5, which using exponents would be 2 squared times 3 squared times 5, which would be 4 times 9 times 5, which equals 180. So 180 is the smallest number that is a multiple of both 36 and 60. It's also the smallest number that is divisible by 36 and 60. Notice how it contains the prime factors of 36 and also the prime factors of 60. I hope you found this helpful.